With the groundbreaking ceremony in February 1969, the construction of our new school was begun. However, long before this event, plans had been underway to make this project possible. Previous to the completion of our school in November, we were on double sessions with Choctawhatchee High School. Choctaw had the morning sessions, and we went from 12:45 p.m. till 6 p.m., which I would honestly never do for school, but you know, they're crazy in 1969 apparently. When we moved into our new building on November 3rd, it was quite a relief to return to a normal schedule. Wall-to-wall carpeting, ceiling-to-floor chalkboards, three-walled rooms, all these contributed to make ours one of the most modern schools in the state. The formal dedication of Walton Beach High School was held in the auditorium Sunday, February 22nd, 1970 at 1:30 p.m. The Honorable Robert L. F. Sykes, representative from 1st District of Florida, gave the dedicatory address. Architect Roy L. Ricks and contractor Raymond L. Dyson presented Mr. Reynolds with the keys to the school, and the fort's been turning up ever since. We all came from different beginnings, different schools, different cities, different states, different countries. After finally getting through the three most awkward years of our lives, we were nervous for a new, incredibly intimidating mountain in front of us, high school. More classrooms, more people, and those terrifying people that towered over us, the seniors. We had no clue what to expect, what our teachers would be like, who we'd sit next to, who we'd eat with? Freshman year. Seems like it was yesterday. But yet so, so far away.
Planking was a thing.
Planking was a strange thing that happened.
What is it? Planking.
Planking
was
yeah.
Planking.
The lanyards out of the pocket. That was real cool freshman year.
Everyone high skirts. Putting feathers in their hair.
The whole frat thing started freshman year.
Oh, the frat life. Mean. Frat life was hard freshman year. The seniors, yeah, that was the thing. Everybody was being frat.
All the football guys, they wore the Sperry's, the khaki shorts, and the blue polos. They wore them every day.
The Polo Ralph Lauren was it, man. There was no Southern Tide to step your game up. It was Polo Ralph Lauren or nothing, man.
Oh, dude, on your chest. The Beats? Wearing the Beats? Yeah, headphones? Yeah. The Beats necklaces? Yeah.
Oh my. I feel like Toms was a thing too back then, because our whole cheer team, we had
I think being awkward was a thing in freshman year.
The Beats necklace, that's just the worst.
Hashtags were very in.
Good call. Yeah, YOLO. Like,
they had a good YOLO. So YOLO was in.
YOLO! Spring break 2012! YOLO!
I think that was the start of like the tall Nike socks. Oh, those are awful.
You gotta wear three pairs of Nike socks.
Hang on, those Nike socks that everybody was wearing. Those were like terrible.
No, dude, remember they used to double and triple layer those too? Like, you were cool if you had like six pairs of socks on at once.
Guys. Every pair of socks that you had on, that's 1 inch of that you added.
We experienced many things throughout our journey in high school. Freshman year was a year of learning new things. The rest of high school is discovering yourself, learning from mistakes, discovering new things. But no matter where we came from, we all ended up in the same place, the fort.
Over the last 8 months, my wife and I, we were kind of on the, we weren't sure we wanted to move to Florida, to be honest with you. We stepped out on faith. We got here to Fort Walton Beach High. And I have to tell you guys that I've never experienced anything like this in a high school. I went to Niceville High School. But when I got to Fort Walton Beach High, I didn't know how much of a family atmosphere you guys had created. I didn't know. And I told my wife, I said, you know, the special thing about Fort Walton Beach is that I want my children to experience what we have going on here. And that is a credit to all the teachers in this room right now today. That is a credit to you guys. The faculty and staff at Fort Walton Beach High School has done a great, great job. I've enjoyed my last 8 months. I can't tell you. I'm so happy. I'm happy. It's been a long time since I've been happy waking up going to work. I'm happy coming to work here. And I thank you guys for that. This school has more tradition than any other school in the county. It has more tradition than any other school in the county. There's only one school in the Panhandle that has a Heisman Trophy winner. We have more kids that have gone on to play high-level college sports than any other school in the county. We have more kids that have made an appearance in some type of professional sports than any other school in the county. We have a strong tradition here. Lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. I want to be your left-hand man. I love you when you're singing that song. And I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. Is this movie that I think you like? This guy decides to quit his job and head to New York City. This cowboy's running from himself. She's been living on the highest shelf. Oh.
We're halfway done with senior year, and it's definitely something that is, you know, we're on for the rest of our lives. So, you know, enjoy it, and, you know, let's have a great rest of the year. Thank you. Spin my head till I'm too dizzy to stand. Sign me up for two, 'cause time, yeah, time, it got the best of me, and you were so gone.
So don't be a fool. I am no good for you. I chewed out your lungs, your lips, and your.
Christmas Connections is the largest student-run community service project in the state of Florida. And what it does is we take the lists of students who are in need from the county, and we give them a comprehensive Christmas. We buy gifts for them, provide them with 10 days of non-perishable food, buy them a dinner that consists of either a turkey or a ham, milk, eggs, bread, you know, perishable stuff. And it's just all about, it's all about making sure those kids have a good Christmas.
I'm Courtney, and I help to run Christmas Connections. Christmas Connections is a program that we do to help families who can't really provide a Christmas for their families.
Interview the families and see what they need, whether it be electrical bills paid, what kind of foods that they're gonna need, what kind of appliances they might need, what the kids want for Christmas. After they do that, we start allotting money to families, figuring out who gets what and how much.
So we collect food and we go to Walmart and buy gifts.
Close down 3 or 4 checkout lanes just for us.
And we come back to the school the night before, or the night of, and we just wrap all the presents and then deliver that night.
And then it's done, and then the kids are hopefully happy. You know, we got guys going and delivering gifts dressed as Santa Claus and that kind of thing, so it's pretty good.
Christmas Connections taught me that it's a good feeling to give a helping hand to families in need.
It teaches me how to, it teaches me that not everybody has everything that I have, and it makes me a lot more grateful for the things that I do have.
Like, because before we actually went and bought all the stuff, we went to their house and met them and like got lists of what they wanted and stuff, and it was just crazy seeing like how much they didn't have.
I know that we have families that were in danger of having their electricity cut out or not having clean water or, you know, simple things like that. They don't have beds to sleep in. They're all living in one room. You know, things like that that I just have never even thought about not having. So it's definitely taught me to be more grateful for things that I have.
And then that made it like, made you want to like, just like participate more and more and like make sure you get exactly what they need, exactly what they wanted, so that you just made sure they had a good Christmas.
lights are blinking. I'm thinking it's all over when I go out drinking. Oh, making my mind slow. That's why I don't f*** with the big boy. Oh, bro, I got to maintain. Cause like me is going insane.
You gotta live up to it now.
Yeah, I gotta have her. Yeah! After this dance and everything, she was sweaty ass blue like that. There was a little weightlifting meet here.
Bush did 9/11.
Look at this, look at this. Jet fuel can't melt steel beams. It can't. I'm gonna get out of my bed till noon. Never smell the perfume
smoke in my room and I got the door closed. What we got? We got some potato, we got some sausage, we got that cooked up, boy. Take your shoes off and kick it back. We escape the world, escape the stress. But I don't give a fuck if the house a mess. Cause we gon' handle that later. We gon' handle that later. Right now let's get this paper and smile for all them haters. Ay, cream cheese and a bagel. Have a glass of milk and an Eggo. I'm rocking PJs and no shirt. Ah, eat yogurt. Enjoy the best things in your life. Cause you ain't gonna get to live it twice. You waste time asleep, but I'm just trying to dream. Supposed to be in class, but I ain't going. Let's chill on the couch. See what's on the telly. Girl, we won't leave the house. Can you stay a while? Can you stay a while? Cause girl, I'm feeling lazy and I'm trying to hang around.
Hitler did nothing wrong.
My name's Peyton Hall, and I live in Fort Walton Beach, and I skateboard. I've been skateboarding since fifth grade. Took over my whole life. I stopped doing any team sports. This thing, it's her fault.
Hi. Kay Chandler, I'm a senior, Fort Walton Beach High School.
and I like to skateboard.
I'm David Beaudry. I'm from Fort Walton Beach, and I do sailboat racing. I've been sailing for about 6 years, but I've only been doing competitive racing for about 4. My dad used to be a professional sailboat racer, so once we moved down here to the beach, he got me involved in it, and I started taking off from there.
It's very relaxing. If you don't want to skate, it's always windy, always on the water. This is a spot I don't mind hurting myself at.
I come here pretty often.
Love Destin. Grew up in Texas, moved to Destin when I was 9, and lived there most of my time in Florida. Oh, I love the water. It's more of a being able to get out in the ocean kind of thing. Like, I like being in the water, just not being all sandy, not being covered in sand. That's definitely not my thing.
So sailing anywhere regardless is great because you're on the water, you're out, you're using the force of nature for a sport. But here on Choctawhatchee Bay, it's really great because you get a great sea breeze, the water's clear, perfect, it's clean, it's always beautiful here. You know, going to other places, you really appreciate what we have back here at home.
Okay, got it. Yeah. You're welcome.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Heck yeah, I was surprised that Lauren got the queen. Like High School Musical. I started thinking High School Musical. We're both in theater. We act, we dance. I'm Troy, she's Gabriella, right? It makes sense. She's really smart. Gabriella's really smart. Zac Efron's sexy. I consider myself sexy. Whenever they said, let's make room for the prom court, and the whole dance floor split in half, you see, that's when it started to get real. And then they said Kenny Fu. Yeah, kind of got like a loud cheer. So, you know, that got my juices flowing. So I started walking out with energy and charisma and gave people high fives and whatnot. Just like you, just like me, we all love each other. We're all one big happy family here. And when y'all started chanting my name, man, did I feel like I could trust you with my life. Did I feel like I was on a team here, where we've been training for like 4 years, because we're one big happy family here.
So what, we get drunk? So what, we don't sleep? We're just having fun. We don't care who sees. So what, we go out?
We get a lighter.
That's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild.
Keep that in there.
Free.
What? I keep them rolled up, sagging my pants, not caring what I show. Keep it real, if you don't know me, keep it playing with my bros. It look clean, don't it? Watch it the other
day. How many people in radio
to find out who the king and queen are for 2015.
The 2015 prom king goes to Kenny Fu.
Your chick smoking gray.
You know what? It's like a 17 again. Peach fuzz on my face. Looking on the case, trying to find a hella taste. Oh my God, I'm on the chase. Chevy, it's getting kind of heavy. Relevant selling me, dipping away. Time keeps slipping away.
And it's your 2015 prom queen goes to Lauren Abel.
Hey John, show up, we don't sleep. So while we go out, that's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild and free.
And I don't even care. Long as me and my team in here, it's gonna be some green in the air. Tell them Mac.
Blowing everywhere we going, and now you know when I step right up. Get my lighter so I can light up.
That's how it should be done. Soon as you thinking you're down, find how to turn things around. Now things are looking up.
From the ground up, pound up this Taylor gang. So turn my sound up and mount up and do my thing.
Now I'm chilling, fresh out of class, feeling like I'm on my own and I could probably own a building. Got my own car, no job, no children. Had a size project, me and Mac killed it.
THC, MAC, DEV, HD3. It's me, this is us. We gon' fuss and we gon' fight and we gon' roll and live
so
our life.
So up we get drunk, so up we don't sleep. We're just having fun, we don't care who sees. So up we go out, that's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild and free.
Ladies have been partying up here in the front all night.
Going down back east.
Look at this.
Tennessee Valley.
That's how you feel?
One arm on the wind.
Where'd they go?
I'm my lover with the other. A sweet, soft, southern thrill.
Let me get on someone's shoulder.
Worked hard all week. Got a little jingle. On a Tennessee Saturday night, couldn't feel better. I'm better with my Dixieland life. Spend my dollar, my beer, walking forward beneath the mountain moonlight.
Wrong side, corner up tight,
hit the wall,
make a little London.
Why are we gonna-
First of all, you're making history. It's like first ever field day Viking Olympics, so awesome.
Feel good scene from Randy came from.
The experience that we have in the student section.
Lights.
Camera. Action!
Probably want to hit that kid in the face.
Okay, well, we all know Ashton's.
My favorite moment has probably been like Chalk Doll Week, just because everybody came together as one for like the final time, and we all just like had a bunch of fun at the game and really supported our team.
Woods crew.
Mine was Senior Skip Day, because I thought that it was cool that everybody came together on the beach.
I got an MIP, so that's a really bad memory.
Where's the alcohol at?
Probably the Chalk Doll game, but the exact moment is probably when during 99 Problems, right before like the beat like dropped, it's like that moment, everyone was like, and then threw up their thing.
Actually, my favorite memory was these two almost getting to a altercation.
Yeah.
Football games.
Definitely football games.
We were all in the large group musical called In from Karen the Musical, and we performed it at Districts, and we won Critics' Choice with it.
But getting to perform that in the theater in Tampa in front of all these people who bought tickets specifically to see us, they didn't just get extra credit on their English assignments.
We
can't hate on the school.
More code.
I like more coke, that's a good answer.
Bone more freshman.
Stay in the weight room.
I wish I could go back to
gone good grades.
I want to go back to freshman year and do my homework.
Played a real sport.
Are you kidding?
I wish I would have appreciated Miss Shirley's class a little bit more.
Been more involved my junior year, because I feel like I missed a lot.
I wish I would have lived every year like I did senior year.
No doubt.
Probably should have tried a little less.
I probably should have tried a little more.
Probably like hung out like with the class like more at the beginning of the year. Because I feel like the beginning of the year like we hung out, but like it wasn't really like this. But like in the end of the year now, it's like this.
I wish I went to more sports events before this year.
Same. I've only ever been to two. I wish I would have been more outgoing. I do.
Yeah. You're pretty flamboyant, I would say.
No, like outgoing, like going to do more stuff with people.
When I was a freshman and I did Stars, I remember the very first game, I was like on 50 and I turned around for like the first like opening pose, and like the stadium was like packed, and I was like, this is crazy.
I gotta say, the first day walking in the freshman year, I could smell the school. It smelled pretty new.
The freshman year homecoming is pretty good because there was a lot of fly honeys there.
One more three camp out.
No doubt. It was 102 versus that, 6 that yeah, night.
Or ESPN day. Like, that was pretty hard.
For you.
Yeah, for you.
I mean, I'm sorry, guys. Yeah. Beating Choctaw, nice fun academic team.
Yes! Running that train. All the the cake.
All the birthdays.
Every day we were
every
eating.
Day.
There was a birthday every day. I swear. There was cake there, everybody was eating.
The teachers.
Shout out to Mark Coach.
Being able to see every single one of my friends every single day.
I'll miss walking the halls. Because like in college you don't really get to walk the halls and it's just it's a whole different experience.
My inheritance.
Okay. Sorry, I'm so excited for that.
That means your parents are gonna die.
No.
Inheritance, like that.
I'm
like, that
I'm getting
whenever...
it from my grandparents.
Okay, next.
never mind.
You know one thing I'm actually really excited for? It's like once I've established myself and I got my place, and I want like this huge, like little big, like balcony thing that's just open and it all looks the woods. And that's where I'm just probably gonna just sit and just like crank it all day. I can't wait for that.
I'm just still waiting for the you're not the dad text right now.
I'm ready to get married, have some kids, man.
I don't feel you.
Have some little mixed babies.
Money.
Money.
College!
Yeah. Excited for college football.
Yeah, we're gonna have a whole bunch of UF Tallahassee connections here. It's going, yeah!
And rushing.
I would say rushing.
I can just go into public and take my shirt and pants off. And that's still legal because I'm exercising my rights.
Kenny, just keep your clothes on, Kenny. Favorite part of teaching is actually having the kids learn something that they may use later on in life, like time management skills or how to study in their dorm room late at night for a college test.
The money.
If you've been in my class, then you know how much I love creepy stories and creepy poems, creepy stuff, hands down.
The students. Most of the time they're fun. I only want to kill them about like Thursdays and Fridays.
It's wonderful to see how a student comes in at the beginning of the year and there's something in there, but they don't quite know how to express themselves. They're a bit awkward. And by the time they're a senior and they're center stage with lights on them and they're commanding an audience of 700 people, there's nothing more rewarding.
How smart and hardworking most of you are. There's a couple of exceptions, but by and large, you guys have done fantastic. I'm so proud of all of you. And I know you'll be highly successful. You're gonna make a ton of money, pay tons of taxes, and I'm gonna live large. Thank you.
You know, personality-wise, they were just an easy group to be around.
I loved the way that you guys started off the year with the water fight. I thought that was pretty classic. Probably should have maybe given some teacher invites.
I have to say how much fun they are, how nice they are, and they're all winners. As a matter of fact, I spend so much of my time on Twitter and Instagram bragging about the next thing that they've won. Track and drama and band and, of course, Austin Shaw, who's filming this right now. Everyone is a winner. And I'm just so proud of this particular group. They're so pleasant to be around. I absolutely love this group.
The seniors I have in that group are just probably the most extraordinary bunch I've ever had. They really are. They can take anything and they can soar with it. And it's that has been a huge joy.
My wave. My wave.
I think sometimes this class has been a tad academically lazy.
Today, or yesterday, this is what my classroom looked like. If you can see in the background, see there, no students. They were supposed to be here, but they didn't come. That was you, Peyton Lockley.
Well, teaching seniors, it's pretty simple. You guys do get pretty lazy toward the end of the year each time.
They're so green.
Oh, I will miss all of you. You guys have been a lot of fun. You really have. You worked really hard. Class has been hard. We had to rush a bunch of stuff in microeconomics, and macro is always hard, and then you had to wait a whole semester. So you guys have done great. I'm very proud of all of you.
It was just an easy group to be around. They were pretty Pretty funny. A lot of them pretty fun. And it's like, I could talk about stuff and people didn't get all, been out of shape about it in my class. So it's always fun when you can just express things without people getting a little bit upset about the little things.
The joy that they give me, they make me laugh. They make me smile. Even when I'm driving in sometimes thinking that I'm having the worst day ever, I'll walk in and they just start making me laugh and smile, and I don't expect to be doing that when I'm in a bad mood. Green.
Fun. I think y'all are fun. Lots came to my mind. I think y'all are very accepting. I think you are, I know it's more than one word, but I really do. I just think y'all have a big heart and you're very accepting.
Relentless.
You guys all know that I can't say a thing in one word. You ask me a question, I'm gonna give you a pretty decent, thorough answer.
I say they're loyal to each other, they're loyal to their school when times got tough a little bit, so I'd say loyalty, definitely.
To really enjoy the moments more, not to worry so much about what was coming the next day or the future, but to just kind of live in the moment and realize that worrying wasn't going to help them work out any better. But I wish that I had not been such a worrier.
I think I would tell myself that it all works out, that you can't worry about the little stuff.
Experience life. No one wants to live with the idea of, I had the opportunity, but I didn't. So take the opportunity when it's there.
When old people tell you you should do something, listen to them, okay? Work hard, have fun, live in the moment. But if you want to have fun tomorrow, you got to work.
There would be such cool hair products later on in life. We did not have the gadgets and the things that make your hair look non-frizzed.
I wish I would have developed a greater appreciation for my hair at age 15. I did not know it would go at such an early rate. You can be whatever you want to be. You can do whatever you want to do. Remember the rock. Remember that every decision that you make has its consequences, both good and bad. Love y'all. Miss y'all.
Do what you love. I really, really wish for every student graduating this year that they're able to find what they love, work hard at it, and enjoy going to work every day like I did in my 39 years of being in education.
Always give it your best shot, never give up, and to remember the people around you and to not forget those who love you and do things for you and to always tell them thank you and that you love them.
Go to college, work your tail off, take hard classes, and don't borrow money. And do good. Get great jobs, make tons of money, pay taxes, lots of them.
Work towards what you love.
There's no greater joy than taking on something that you didn't think you could do and doing it. Other than that, have fun, enjoy life, and don't worry too much about what other people think about you. Know yourself and embrace what you like to do.
Do everything that Forrest Gump did. And don't do anything that Jenny did.
First, I'm going to say to enjoy college or whatever it is you happen to do in your life. But remember that it's sort of like getting your license when you're 16. You're ready for it, but you're not ready for that. It's fantastic to have the freedom. It's scary and sometimes dangerous. But who really wants to go back and not have your license? Just remember to drive carefully, all right? No matter where you're going and what you're doing. In college, you're gonna have a lot of choices to make, and it's gonna be exciting and fun. You'll make a lot of good memories. Just be aware of the goals that you actually have. Maintain those goals, be safe, arrive safely. And I definitely want to see all of your beautiful faces later on when you come back possibly to visit or just see you on Facebook, Twitter, whatever it is. And just enjoy the ride.
Spirited. Oh my word, I think this year, you know, we had the transfers, but you were very spirited. You wanted them to know that they could leave if they wanted to, but you were staying behind because this was your school and you were gonna cheer for it, you were gonna yell for it, and as the spirit video said, it didn't matter what the score was. Those were our people on the field, and we were going to be there for them to the bitter end. And I think that is such a tribute to your class.
Spirit, this has been a rough year, and I think that you guys did a phenomenal job of spirit.
The student section? Yeah, it was exciting, and even watching the videos afterwards and the cleanup afterwards, because usually I was there, it was a mess, but I loved it.
Y'all stayed together during a very difficult year. The spirit that you guys and gals showed in a year that could have been a lot worse kept the entire school going, and I appreciate it. I've never seen it before.
There were many a night when we were getting beaten, and I would look up there and y'all would still be cheering, that I would have almost tears streaming down my face. The loyalty to the school and your commitment to the school and the community was so strong, and I'll always be grateful to this class for that.
As we sail off and go our separate ways, we will always share one common thing, the fort. It doesn't matter if you are here for a semester or all 4 years, the colors red, white, and blue will mean so much more to you than just American. It represents a place where you're the craziest and worst times, where an AP Calc test made your brain fuzzy, and a prep rally made your adrenaline start pumping, where our last football season reminded us of High School Musical and gave a new meaning to We're All In This Together. Whether it's smiling back to pictures from the infamous Choctaw game, or reminiscing at our last prom, we will know that memories will fade and stories will become foggy, but pictures will bring you back to where it all started. T-U-O-T.
Are we live?
Yeah.
Testing, testing.
Make a little loving all night.
And of course, big shout out to my aide and one of my all-time favorite students, Miss Kristen Hyder. Love you, miss you. Come see me in Charleston.
2015?
Probably being informed that I was the runner-up for a senior crush, and I just want to know who beat me.
Coach, I need you offset. Don't make me lock this door. Do you want to go ahead? What a jerk, man.
Now you're in.
You're in.
We got him.
Coach Steele, senior video. Let's go.
I know. Banana Man.
Hey, Johnny Cash. Yeah. Chill out.
Walk the line.
Okay. Coach Steele has been my work wife for 15 years.
Strong years.
Jimmy. Oh, my God. Jimmy Pierce. How can I forget Jimmy? Jimmy Pierce is one of the most brilliant students I've ever taught, one of the most clueless students I've ever taught, writes at a level that is way above a high school student. He's insightful, he's an incredible performer, and he cannot keep up with his keys, or his homework, or his phone.
You know, a lot of people ask me how I do this, and I tell them often.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Spring break.
Spring break!
Class of 2015, arrivederci.
Hasta lasagna.
Hasta la vista.
Ciao, baby.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Goodbye.
Ciao, bella.
Hey, who turned out the lights?
Konnichiwa.
Nagasaki.
He's a good-looking guy right here. Bye.
Bye.